Christians and all that. And the Most High say, I have set this so. So the Most High put this up for a period of time. Wow. And we come to the end of that period of time right now. This is why you see me men outside here. Because Allah always said, we are here just so. We're not just here to just wash up and stuff going on down the road there. We actually here to bring education to the people of the nation and Israel beginning to elect.
Proverbs 28 and 12. When the righteous men do rejoice, there is great glory. But when the wicked rise, a man is hidden.
We have a God-given opportunity to make history. Something is missing. Silent.
Isaiah chapter 24.
This is the word, but we need to have it. Without actions is dead.
So it's the tribe under the inhabitants thereof, because they have transgressed the laws, changed the ordinance, broken the everlasting covenant. Therefore had the cause of God the earth, and they that dwell therein are desolate. Therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burned, and few men left.
Yes, we say what we say. Because covenant, right? And somebody give me Revelation 22. This verse 6.
This is Revelation of the 22 and verse 6. And he said unto me, these sayings are faithful and true. This is Revelation of the 22 and verse 3. And there shall be no more curse for the throne of Yahweh, and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servant shall serve it.
Revelation chapter 2 verse 9. I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich.
Thou art rich. Are we rich? Right now we poor. Right now we crying. Where right now we sign, David say what? Sign and cry. Basically come like a daily life. By that day when the Lord take us out of this mountain, this captivity, we're gonna inherit the kingdom. We're gonna inherit the riches of the world.
Right.
So when the Lord say, but thou art rich, because in future tense, we're gonna inherit all things.
That's right.
But currently right now we're rich in this world, rich in this knowledge. Right? Because the scripture come here, wisdom unto peace. Right.
And I know the blasphemy of them that say they are children, and are not, but that a second prayer of his head.
Yeah, and I talk about IUIC or them men, but also talk about them modern day Jews, them so-called Jews. Alright? The synagogues of Satan. Right, because a couple of years ago, I had this I can't remember his name, but it was actually a Jew. And he came out and basically says, because he's the devil, we are not the chosen people of the Lord. Him and his people are the devils. I think a month after that documentary, they find him dead.
Luke chapter 22 verse 65. So many other things blasphemously speak here against the Lord.
Yeah, and that is what the scripture talk about in 2 Thessalonians 3. We talk about them who oppose themselves against the Mosai and everything that caught by the Mosai. And that is the twin. Yeah, I think it's in the cathedral, they show the Adam and the Mosai touching the people, both of them pale as hell. Alright, calling themselves before the people. And that is what they're doing, they're just speaking lies against the Lord. Alright?
This is...
This Job, chapter 31, verse 38, it says, if my land cry against me, or that the pharaohs likewise yell complain, if I have eaten the fruits thereof without money, or have caused the owners thereof to lose their life, let crystals go instead of wheat, and cattle instead of land.
Yeah, and there's no good white man crying against the soul of a white man. The white, because when Lamentations 4, I think it's chapter 4, yes, not chapter 4, it's chapter 5, it says that our bread is sold unto us. And that is what we actually labor. This land belongs to these people that most native tribes. Alright, but it being sold unto them, food and water being sold unto them. Scripture talk about the inhabitants die. And he slaughtered them. He slaughtered millions, like Christopher Columbus. Alright? But guess what? Vengeance coming, and this hope they could endure. That's not how we endure. Alright? And this hope they could endure. Alright? And that is what we're doing right now. Because they deprived the land crying against them. That is why they're pushing all them GMO. Because why the land can't bring forth in the US. Now when Isaiah 14 says what? The politics has wrecked. Even the third trees rejoice and the box. Because just the other day I watched this article that a man buy 400 acres of forest in the Amazon just so that the white man can't go and cut it up. Just so that he can preserve that area. Scripture talk about destroying them and destroying the so-called white man everywhere. The scripture say that who enlarges his borders basically as death and hell. And that is the so-called white man.
None.
Right? That is the so-called everywhere he goes, death is following one step. Everything you should have upon this is going to talk about it. Stamping the rest of the pieces, everything is stamping the pieces. Right?
Right? Yeah, can I come off it?
Come off it?
Yeah. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 6. It says, folly is set in a great, folly is set in a great dignity, and the rich sit in low places.
Yeah, the rich sit in low places, but we are the rich. Alright? The scripture said, the earth is mine, the gold is mine, the silver is mine. So if all that is in your sight, and we will inherit them things belong to us. Right? And folly, somebody can follow this program. Folly is set in great dignity, we want. When you get here to do it, all they're gonna do is destroy you.
Psalms 119 and 53. Horror had taken hold upon me because of the wicked that forsake thy law.
Yeah, the wicked that forsake thy law. And that is what we actually forsake to everybody. Alright? Right now in over the Middle East, when they call him so-called white man, they call him Red Satan. Alright? Red Dragon, that is what they call him. Because why? If these people over here tell that the so-called white man is an angel, they're gonna take a trip over the Middle East. They're gonna take a trip and they'll see how much, how sinister the so-called white man really is. Alright,
Proverbs chapter 29 and verse 16. When the wicked are multiplying, transgression increases.
Yeah, when the wicked are multiplying, that's in our mind. I guess it was happening. Understand? It says, when the wicked multiply, transgression increases. Alright? Because the so-called white, is the basis of all creatures that the Lord made. Alright? Job people say he don't want to keep them among the dogs that he flock. You understand? So that is the so-called white man. The so-called white man is actually scum on the whole earth. Alright? And by the Lord exalting the so-called white man over us, is actually putting Israel to great shame. Then as the Lord taking a dog and putting it to rule over kings. And that is exactly what he did.
But the righteous shall see their fall.
Yeah, that is what we hoping to see. We hoping to stand and to see fall the so-called white man. Alright, that is what we enjoy to see. Right?
This is Ezekiel chapter 7 verse 23. It says, they get changed, for the land is full of bloody Christ and the city is full of violence.
Yeah.
It says, wherefore I will bring the worst of the heathen, and they shall possess their houses. I will also make the pomp of the strong to cease, and their holy places shall be defied.
Yeah, and God say how I am the hammer, the whole world cover. And I will love and the Lord gonna destroy all the dwellings of the so-called white man. The scripture said that the peace and the false prophet that look miracles gonna be cast into the lake of fire. He saw it. Yeah. So-called white man gonna be destroyed. He's gonna be wiped off the face of the earth. All the monuments he set up in remembrance of him. Gonna be cast off. Right? In times to come, people are gonna say he saw it. It's not going to be a dream because you can say after many years it shall be visited. So after 1,000 years of slavery, so called white man going to be wiped out. Right?
Hallelujah. Psalms 58 and 10. The righteous shall rejoice when he seeth men the vengeance. He shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked.
Yeah, he shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked. Just like Yahweh shed Isaiah 63, he said he go through to thresh my press. Scripture said, we shall return to judge among many nations. So just like Yahweh Shai, we're going to come conquering to conquer. We're going to come conquering to conquer. Scripture said, though are my battle axe. Right? And we're going to take, the scripture said, we're going to take jealousy for our soul or something like that. In that day, the Lord actually can increase the hatred that we already have in the so-called white man. The hatred that we already have, the Lord can increase it. We're gonna hear his soul so much till you might actually see steams coming out of the head.
This is Isaiah chapter 14, start of verse 20.